Hello friends, in my this video, I am going to discuss some important concepts on Shannon's theorem. So, if you have studied wireless and mobile communication or analog communication or digital communication or satellite communication, that is any communication related course, then you might have studied this formula, which is basically base or frame of any communication system, that is C equal to B log 1 plus SNR, where base of log is 2, and this C is basically channel capacity for AWGN channel, which is obviously whose unit is bits per second, right? Now this B is nothing but channel bandwidth, and this S by N is nothing but this S is signal power, N is noise power, right? Now always, as a engineer of electronics and communication engineer point of view, always our intention is to make channel capacity as high as possible, so that data rate or bit rate is very high, but in that same time we should also keep quite attention in this fact that the probability of error or the bit error rate should not be very high. It should be very low, as close to zero, as much low as possible. Okay, so basically this is the formula what Shannon has given. Now, if we want to increase this channel capacity, this C, you tell me, what should I do? See, from the expression itself, it is quite clear that channel capacity depends on bandwidth and SNR, right? S by N. That's what I have written here, that the channel capacity depends on two factors. One is bandwidth, another one is SNR. But see, if we want to increase the channel capacity, it may appear that the better option is to increase the bandwidth, because if we increase the bandwidth, proportional to that channel capacity will increase, because C is directly proportional to bandwidth. But really, if you want to increase the channel capacity by increasing the SNR or signal to noise ratio, then see, the channel capacity is related to the SNR in terms of log function. That means it is not proportional relationship, right? So it might appear that the efficient way to increase the channel capacity is increase the bandwidth. But what will happen if you increase the bandwidth up to infinity? That is, if your channel has infinite bandwidth, then whether we will get infinite channel capacity? That is the discussion of our this video. Okay, so slowly by slowly we'll go. So see, channel capacity depends on two factors. One is bandwidth, another one is SNR, which is quite clear from the mathematical expression itself. And bandwidth appears as better option to increase the capacity, as channel capacity is directly proportional to bandwidth, right? Now see, just you consider any wireless communication. Always, most of our wireless communication has wireless communication signals are basically band limited. Okay, so to consider this diagram, just forget about this N0 by 2 straight line parallel to frequency axis. Just to consider these two graphs, okay, these are nothing but modulated message signal, and the message signals are modulated for which carrier frequency or central frequency is F0. So here F0 and here minus F0, and the message has bandwidth of B. Okay, so basically this is our graph, like AM, how you have studied, that only is basically before transmitting through a channel, we first modulate our message signal through a high frequency carrier. So that carrier frequency is F0 and the message has bandwidth B. Simple, right? Now you know that the power spectral density of the AWGN, that is additive white Gaussian noise, is basically this one. That is N0 by 2, that is, it is constant throughout the whole frequency range, and the value is N0 by 2. This is the power spectral density for additive white Gaussian noise. Now, our message is confined within this bandwidth B, right? And here also, if the central frequency is minus F0, then our message is confined here, right? Now, if we want to consider SNR for our communication, what we will do? our intention will be to calculate the noise which is basically confined in this region of bandwidth B and here in this region of bandwidth B, right? So basically that's what I have drawn here. So now just remove those message signals. Just I have shown you the modulation so that I have drawn here the messages are basically from the baseband. It is modulated to a certain carrier frequency of central frequency F0 so that I have drawn these lobes. Now if you consider only the noise which is there in the bandwidth B, what will be that value? Basically we have to integrate. Now if we do the integration, basically nothing but the area under this curve and it will be equal to N0 by 2 into B. That is, the noise confined in this particular shaded region is N0 by 2 into B. But our message is not only confined in this region, rather our message is also confined in this region. That is, in this region as well as in this region. In both regions, our message is there. Because wireless communication system, as I told you before transmitting, we modulate that, and when modulate two frequency, one is negative side carrier frequency minus F0 and in the positive side plus F0, and in these two in beside these two central frequencies throughout the bandwidth B, our message is there, right? So basically if we want to consider the total amount of noise, we should consider this part also. There is noise confined in this region also, and that will be basically this graph, and that will be nothing but total power will be the total area confined under this region and as well as this shaded region, and that will be equal to Pn equal to N0 by 2 into B into 2. That is, total noise power in our particular wireless communication is N0 into B if our communication is confined or band limited within B bandwidth. Okay, so this is our noise part, where N0 is nothing but, if you have studied noise module in analog and digital communication, then you know that the N0 value is Ta into Ts, where Ts is the temperature of the system, which is expressed in Kelvin, and K is the Boltzmann constant, right? So I am not going in that detail. So basically our intention is to calculate the S by N for our this channel. So for that we have calculated Pn, that is noise power, is equal to N0 into B. This is total noise power, right? Now see, here comes the important concept. The total amount of noise in our communication is also proportional to the bandwidth of our system, that is bandwidth of our message in which we are transmitting the through the channel. That message bandwidth, the total amount of noise power is also proportional to that. From the expression itself it is clear. Now see, C is equal to B into log 1 plus S by N, where log base is 2. Why 2? Because perform wireless and mobile communication in terms of digital signals. Okay, digital communication. So digital signals are basically binary number 0 and 1, so that log base 2, right? These basic things you might have known. Now see, instead of this noise power, we can put the value which we derived, that is N0 into B, right? So basically we can get this expression, that is C is equal to bandwidth into log 1 plus signal power by N0 into B. Okay, and here base is 2. Now see, what was the question or what was the aim of for this video? That to check whether we can achieve infinite capacity or huge capacity by increasing the bandwidth. From the expression, if you just simply check the expression, from the mathematics it says, simply if you observe channel capacity proportional to bandwidth, so if bandwidth is infinity, channel capacity is infinity. But no, this is not going to happen. Why? See, C is equal to limit B tends to infinity, B log 1 plus S by N0 into B. Okay. Now, see, as bandwidth goes to infinity, this term will increase. Okay, fine. But see, this N0 into B, here also B is there. So, N0 into B will increase. So, S by N0 into B will decrease. So, basically, this factor log 1 plus S by N0 into B will decrease if bandwidth goes to infinity, right? It will decrease very much. So, what will happen? Basically, although this term increases, but the second term decreases. So, as a result, channel capacity is not possible to achieve as infinite value when bandwidth is infinity. Rather, we will get a finite channel capacity if bandwidth is infinity, right? So that's what I have written here. If bandwidth goes to infinity, noise power increases, because noise power is nothing but n naught into p. So as a result, signal to noise power decreases. Hence, even if bandwidth approaches infinity, channel capacity does not approach infinity. And here comes the very important quote, and this you should always remember while designing a circuit as a communication engineering point of view, that is, infinite bandwidth channel has limited capacity. Because if although bandwidth becomes infinity and bandwidth proportional to channel capacity, that is channel capacity proportional to bandwidth, so the channel capacity should also go to infinity, but channel capacity also depended on the signal to noise power, which increases as bandwidth increases. So at infinite bandwidth we get limited capacity. Although if you simply see the mathematical expression, it appears that we may achieve infinite channel capacity by increasing the bandwidth up to infinity. But no, it is not going to happen. Just now I have explained in detail. So I hope you have understood this concept. One more concept you can interpret from here, that what is the channel capacity for a noiseless channel? See, now try to understand. Noiseless channel means n equal to 0. N equal to 0 means s by n is infinity. That is log of 1 plus infinity. This is log of infinity. And log of infinity is how much? Infinity. So channel capacity will achieve infinite value in that time, right? So basically, channel capacity will become infinite for a noiseless channel. But you know, in practical, no channel is noiseless, right? There are multiple reasons due to which noise is generated in the channel or in the transmitter or in the receiver, so that we cannot, can never achieve channel capacity as infinite value. Whether you make bandwidth as infinity or you make noise as zero. Okay. So these are two very important concepts in Shannon's theorem. Number one is infinite bandwidth never makes channel capacity as infinity. Rather, channel capacity will reach to a certain value, and your noiseless channel has infinite channel capacity. Okay, I hope you have understood this. This is all for my this video. Thank you for watching.